Microsoft Teams has quickly become the platform where we get work done, sharing files, meeting with colleagues, and even sharing news. With additional apps, Microsoft Teams can truly shine as a platform, living up to its full potential and remaining at the heart of your workday. This Easter, my Modern Work Customer Success team and I want to showcase our favorite applications and experiences inside of Microsoft Teams, and so we've gone hunting. And I want to start us off today with a great one. Polly has long been a fantastic application for running polls and quizzes inside of Microsoft Teams with your colleagues. But now you can actually leverage Polly to build Q&A support directly into your Teams meetings. No longer do you have to use a live event to get a Q&A format. So let's go over to Teams and have a look at that experience ourselves.
So in Teams, I've already created a meeting for this occasion. I'm going to go ahead and add a tab and search for Polly to find it from the list. I'll simply select it from this option and you'll see it's an optimized for meeting experience, meaning it's going to customize the Teams meeting itself. I'll add it in here and follow all the necessary steps to get Polly added as a tab. Then I'll create and from the list, I'll choose a Q&A. I'm going to modify the default, do you have any questions, to simply add something about today's content. And I'll require, and I can check the question approval button to see if I want to actually approve Q&A remarks before they're seen by everyone. With that selected, I'm going to go ahead and make sure that it is ready for the session, and then I'll join the Teams meeting. In the Teams meeting now, I see at the top of the side of my screen, Polly is its own separate icon. And if I click Polly from this list, you'll see I can actually load up the questions and the Q&As that we've built. So if you have quizzes, this is where you'll find them. From here though, I want to start the Q&A, and what's going to show up front and center of my screen is an invitation for the audience to ask questions, as well as to actually participate in the Q&A page, which they can now do by clicking on Polly at the top of the meeting, and this will be made available for everyone. Let's go ahead and see what it's like to submit a question. I'll simply ask a curiosity around how this is going to improve the meeting engagement inside of the Teams experience. So let's write that in, and I'm going to send this question anonymously. Your audience will be able to do this. And now you can see on the right-hand side, in my admin view, I've got one question submitted. Now to actually answer those, we need to join the Q&A. From here, you'll see three pages just like a Teams Live event, approved, reviewed, and dismissed. With that original comment that was written in from anonymous, obviously myself, I can go ahead and reply and enter something here in the meeting, and then send that off to the person who asked the question. I'll then hit the tick to push it to answered, and that's now out of the way, helping me manage a large number of questions. I can also post the questions here as an announcer, in a way to actually broadcast them out to everyone. And then when I'm done, I'll go ahead and select Polly once more to close, and then leave the Teams meeting experience. Easy as that.
I hope you enjoyed that look at Polly's Q&A experience inside of Teams. It truly opens so many possibilities for how you might use a Microsoft Teams meeting. Stay tuned this week as my team and I continue to showcase our favorite applications inside of Teams. If you'd like to easily stay in the know, the link on screen, aka.ms/EasterAppHunt, will take you to our central LinkedIn article with all of the posts and videos. Have a great Easter, everyone.